So finally, we can get the best developer experience for Python type checking. Astral, the company behind Draft, the best Python linter and formatter, and UV, the best package manager, are working on a new tool called TI, a type checker to replace MyPy and PyRate. This is great news for all Python developers, but it will be especially good for existing big unannotated codebases, continuous integration pipelines, and developer experience for no Vim, by the way, users. So let me show you the tool. At first, what is this all about? If you already know about type annotations, you can skip this part and go to the next section. For who's who stay, check out following code. This function contains errors that will 100% occur in runtime, and this is the reality of Python development. We don't check the types of our variables, but Python have a tool to help us with that, type annotations. And with type annotations, we can explicitly mark the types of our arguments, return values, and variables. This way, we now can use static type checkers to make sure that our code is correct, at least in terms of types, before we even commit and run it. For example, MyPy, a de facto standard for type checking in Python, for this code will throw us an error. This is great, and I personally use type annotations and type checking in 99% of my code, using MyPy in my CI pipelines and another type checker, PyRite, locally in my editor. But there are problems with existing type checkers that TI is trying to solve. The main goal for Astral is to create better developer experience. One of example of this is that existing type checkers are slow. MyPy, for example, requires for up to 20 seconds for my project for initial run, and it hits hard for occasional development checks and in CI pipelines. Let me show you a benchmark example. So I run all these tools on 109k lines of code project, Django. So MyPy is the slowest here. First run takes 35.2 seconds. Second run, after no or little code changes, is better, and it's around 13 to 14.7 seconds, depending on the changes I made. Then, PyRite is just a bit better, every run is about 11.5 seconds. And finally, the TI, blazing fast with 311 milliseconds on every run. This is 35 to 40 times faster compared to existing tools and 135 times faster than cold MyPy run. Even if I remove cold MyPy run from the chart, it's still hard to see TI bar. Okay, so performance is great, but it's not only what made TI better. Another problem with existing type checkers is how they treat unannotated code. TI is designed to be used in existing working code bases. There, they often don't have type annotations, but we want to introduce them gradually. So it's better in terms of how it analyzes types. It will try hard to figure them out even without type annotations. And moreover, its developer team is focusing on reducing amount of false positives. There, the type checker thinks that there is a problem with working code. Let me show you some more examples. Check out this code. On these lines, we can statically infer that the type of the variable could be none, and this line will throw an exception on empty card. MyPy will not catch this error because the function is not unannotated, and it will not even try to check it. TY is focused on gradual typing, so it will try to analyze this code also and give us the error we want. Okay, and check out another interesting example. Same here, we have a simple function where we can find the problem statically. And again, MyPy will say that everything is fine here, even if you add type annotations. And TY will catch this error again. It will still find it, even if we complicate the code a bit. Okay, and another improvement is the better error messages. Check out this example. The problem is that we are trying to call the function with too many arguments. Both MyPy, PyRite, and TY will catch this error, but here are the messages they provide. So, MyPy first, it shows the error and what happens, too many arguments. It also shows the function name and a line number where a call is happening, but it doesn't tell us what the correct number of arguments, and it doesn't show the actual code here. We can still get it tuning on parity mode, but it doesn't show us code context. Then PyRite. This time it doesn't show us function name, and if we are passing few or too many arguments, it just tells us that the function expects one argument. And now compare it with TY. It shows us everything we need. What happened, in which function, what is expected, and actual number of arguments, and even error context. So it's easier to see what's happening. We have a clear winner here. So, and last improvement with TY is that it's designed to backup the language server. A bit of background here. Language server protocol is used by the most modern editors to provide language features like auto-completion, go-to definition, etc. In Python, auto-completion and static analysis done by language servers requires typing information. One of the most popular current LSP server is PyWrite, used in VS Code as a part of PyLens extension. And TI is going to be better than it in terms of every aspect we mentioned and more. It's designed to be incremental, so it's going to provide lower latency and better developer experience as a result. And PyLens, being good, is closed proprietary software. You cannot use it in editor of your choice, only VS Code. So for users of some not-so-popular editors like NeoVim, Zed, Helix, Emacs, things are going to be much better with TI. Yeah, and with the improvements, there are some downsides too. TI is in early development stage, so currently it doesn't have many features, still have many false positives and misses some errors. The team is working on it, and knowing Astral, it will improve very fast. It's also not going to have plugin system like MyPy do, so integration with some frameworks and libraries requiring plugins will be harder. And finally, it's one more tool to install and maintain. MyPy is probably not going anywhere for a while, and we will get yet another split in ecosystem, like it's now with Pip, Poetry and UE. Okay, and that's all for today. Subscribe to get more videos like this, and I will see you in the next one.